I'd like to start by noting that I talk with a stutter. So if I get stuck today, please, bear with me. So today, we're here to talk about House Bill 2268, which addresses childhood onset stuttering. What that is, it's kids 2 to 6. That is when most kids get diagnosed with a speech disorder. Very similar to what I have today and what I have dealt with my entire life. I didn't talk till I was 3, attended speech therapy at Children's Hospital in downtown Pittsburgh. Developed a very bad stutter that I had for most of my childhood, and here I am now talking in front of the Pennsylvania General Assembly about stuttering. Thank you. So House Bill 2268 has really been something that I've been proud to sponsor, and it has really gone through the process. I wouldn't be standing here today unless I really started to thank, first off, the speech therapists that have helped me get to this point. I still see a speech therapist to this day. That being said, former NBA player Michael Kidd-Gilchrist, who talks with a stutter, he played 8 years for the Charlotte Bobcats. He now travels the country advocating for bills very similar to this. So here we are today. So what does House Bill 2268 do? It provides insurance coverage for children ages 2 to 6. That is when most children that are diagnosed with a stutter, it gets caught. Mine got caught at age 3, sometimes it's age 2, sometimes it's age 6. When you can catch stuttering early, a lot of good things can happen. You can seek treatment. People start to understand your problem. Teachers see you differently. When I was in school, I got set to the side of the classroom and was treated differently than my peers. Got teased, picked on, bullied. It wasn't fun. So given my position now, talking in front of you, I feel it proper that I give a voice to those that sometimes don't. And it's really taken me a lot of practice, therapy. I still use some of the techniques that I learned in speech therapy today. So it's really come very much full circle. What I would really like to touch on is the suicidal impacts of kids and adults that stutter. So most people that stutter grow out of it by age 18. About 20% of folks that stutter grow out of their stutter by age 18. Of that 20%, roughly 40 to 50% experience some form of suicidal thoughts. So that's a pretty heavy number when you think about it. Because when you think about people that stutter, it's not something you want to go around talking about. You take it and you go home and you close the door and you kind of don't really feel good about your day when you stutter. I mean, I stutter almost every day, and even for me, some days are good and some days are bad. But to that point, I don't let it define me. And today, we're taking a step to guarantee that children, mind you, children, where we can catch it, treat it, might not be able to stop it, but if we can at least get kids the treatment they need, we can get Pennsylvania children headed in the correct direction in terms of getting them treatment, getting them to see a qualified speech therapist, and hopefully if they don't grow out of it, at least they feel confident where they can see a person like myself, who's a politician standing in front of 200 of my colleagues, who if I would have told you 15 years ago I'd be standing here, I would have said you're out of your mind. And here I am in my third term. Enjoy the job, I love it. And I think, you know, giving a voice to those that sometimes don't is vital. And I think Today, with House Bill 2268, we're taking that small step in the correct direction. So I just want to say thank you for your support and look forward to the vote today. Thank you very much.